Okay, welcome to this series. In this series, I'm going to be talking about keywords and how they can be used in your ad set. Now, first of all, we need to understand what keywords are and how they can be used. Before I dive into my slides on definition and a differentiation of the different types of keywords, I'm going to do one or two tests. Now, let's look at it. If a user wants to buy a particular product, for example, a black shoe. Now, the user does not have any company in mind where he or she can actually purchase the black shoe from. The user goes on Google to do a search using the word black shoe. Then, if the user does this search on Google, Google searches the internet and brings out results based on the keyword that this user have actually imputed into the search engine. Now, let's take this as an example. Now, that doesn't mean I want to buy a black shoe. All I just need to do is to come to Google and type in what black shoes. Let's assume I want to do a search of black shoes for guys. I'll click on black shoes for guys. Now, what happens? The result that is going to come up at this result, if you notice, I have different companies actually showing up black shoes. Reason why these companies are showing up black shoes is because they've used black shoes as a keyword in either their ad set or during the setting up of the SEO of the website of the company. Now, it is very important that we use keywords. We have these results showing up based on the keyword that the user actually typed in into the search engine. Now, if you look at it, I have different companies showing up results of black shoes. Now, let's go into my slides. Let's see the three different types of keywords that can be used on Google. We have the first one, which is called the... Now, we have three types of keywords. We have the first one, which is called the broad match. We have the second one, which is called the phrase match. And we have the third, which is called the exact match. And now, how do you differentiate between these three keywords? The first has, which is the broad match, has no special symbol. The second, which is the phrase match, has phrase covering, or rather the keyword is enclosed in a phrase, a double quotation, a phrase match. We have the exact match, and we have the special character or the special symbol for an exact match to be a closed bracket. So whenever you see a keyword in this form or without a special symbol, then you know that this stands for a broad match, while this stands for a phrase match, and this goes for what? An exact match. All right, what is the definition of a broad match, or when do I say a keyword is categorized under broad match? Now, basically, broad match is a keyword match type that search engines used to determine which search term your ads are eligible to match against. It is called broad match. Now, because it allows your ad to match the widest range of possible keyword searches that are still somewhat related to your keyword, I'm going to be showing us one or two examples on broad match. Now, let's go further about definition of broad match before we take one or two examples on broad match. Now, broad match, let's consider if your ad contains, your ad group contains the keyword tennis, your ad would be eligible to appear when a user search query contains tennis and shoes in any other, and possibly along with other themes. Your ad could also show for singular, plural forms, synonyms, and other relevant variations. For example, your ad might not show on tennis shoe or tennis sneakers. For example, your ad might show on tennis shoe or tennis sneakers. So basically, these options let you pick a theme related to your business and attempt to discover other themes that search engines deem relevant. Now let's think about it. Tennis shoes. I actually use the keyword tennis shoes for my ad set. And if a user goes on a search engine and searches using the query or using the keyword called tennis shoe, and in my there is tendency that my ad is going to show up to that user. Now let's think about it. If the user searches for a theme using tennis sneakers, I would also show up as a broad match. Reason, because there is a theme in my keyword called tennis that it was being used by the search, by the user who is trying to search for a sneakers. The user actually typed in tennis sneakers. And remember, I have a theme, a keyword theme called tennis shoes. Also, in the other way, if a user comes in to your search engine and searches for tennis boots, I am going to show up as well, because there's a theme in my keyword which is called tennis. All right, let's go further. Examples of broad match. This is default option. If your ad group contains the keyword tennis shoes, your ad will be eligible to a user's search query contained tennis shoe. Now let's consider these examples. We have the first, tennis shoes, discount tennis shoes. That means when a user searches for the keyword using discount tennis shoes, there's tendency that your ad is going to show up. Reason, because you used in your keyword, your keyword contains the word tennis and also contains the word shoes. Now if the user searches for cheap tennis shoes, your ad is going to show up because there's a term in your keyword called tennis shoes. Likewise, if your user searches for Converse tennis shoes, there's a term in your keyword called tennis shoes. All right, let's consider these tennis ratchets. There's tendency that you're going to show up because there's a word in your keyword called tennis. Tennis equipment, there's also a word in your keyword called tennis equipment. Now let's go for that. Exact match. Let's consider the exact match. Exact match is a keyword that match your ad types. Exact match keywords allow you to reach prospects searching only for the specific keyword you are bidding on, or close variations of that keyword. Now look at it. Note, bidding on exact keywords allow you to exercise tight control over your advertising budget, giving you a better return on investment on your advertisement. A keyword is matched exact when the keyword is entered in this format. Example, tennis shoes. Now let's consider something. Now, exact match query: jobs in the United States, Nike shoes women. Now let's consider the query. It can actually come this way: jobs in the United States, Nike shoes for women. What happened? Why it matched? Function word added. Now I'm trying to let you understand that this word jobs in United States is the same thing as job in the United States. Reason why I would say they are both the same is because a word function was added. And what's the word function? D. Now let's consider this other one, parks in Abuja. Let's look at the queries, parks Abuja. Now if you consider it, there's a word, a function word that's actually removed from this original keyword, which is in. Now if I would consider both of them, parks in Abuja is automatically the same with the word parks Abuja. Now let's consider this, news from today, news for today. Now this, there's a change in the function words from the word from today and for today. Now let's go further. Phrase match. If you enter your keyword in quotation marks as in tennis shoes in this form, your ad would be eligible to appear when a user searches the phrase tennis shoes in this order. Only possible, and possibly with other theme before or after the phrase. For example, your ad could appear for the query red tennis shoes, but not for shoes, for tennis. Do you get that right? Tennis shoe or tennis sneakers. Phrase match is more targeted than broad match, meaning that if you in your ad said you actually used the phrase match and it's in this form, the phrase match in your quotation, enclosed in a quotation, right? Just like this, we have this quotation, double quotation mark, and then your keyword is enclosed right inside. Then a user goes and searches for the word red tennis shoes, there's tendency you're going to show up, because there's a function, there's a word that was added to that tennis shoes which is not inside the phrase. There's tendency that you're going to show up. But if I had something like this, tennis shoe, I am not going to show up, because in the phrase I had tennis shoes and a user searched for tennis shoe. There's, if you look at it, these two words are not the same. Tennis shoe and tennis shoes, they are not the same. So because they are both in enclosed, the actual word is in a phrase, is enclosed in this phrase, in this quotation mark, and I have an exact word that looks like it as my search query, I am not going to show up. Or I use the word tennis sneakers in my query, or in my keyword I had tennis shoes, and a user comes into a search engine and searches for tennis sneakers, I am not going to show up, or rather my ads is not going to show up. Now, phrase match is more targeted than broad match, but more flexible than exact match. So working off the above tennis shoes analogy, creating a phrase match for tennis shoes would result in the following potential results. Let's check it out. Phrase match examples, creating a phrase match for tennis shoes. Let's check it out. The results will be in the following potential matches. That means if I'm creating an ad, and a Google ad, and I have this as my keyword, the potential results I'm going to get is this when a query is done on this keyword, tennis shoes. Now, my ad is going to show up when someone searches for the exact word, which is tennis shoes. Right, it's going to show up when someone searches for best tennis shoes, because the word tennis shoes was what is in the phrase. That means I'm trying to make you understand that I could use something like bad tennis shoe and I'm going to show up. Yes, if then I'll be talking about negative keyword in a bit, I'll something like worst tennis shoes, and then your ad shows up. I'll give you the reasons why your ad shows up when negative words are being used, and I'll tell you how to actually take good care of those things so that your ads don't show up for negative keywords. Now, I have another one, which is tennis shoes for sale. Remember, in the previous slide, I said it's either a word is added after the keyword that you added to your ads. Do you get that? Now, for example, somebody's searching for the word tennis shoes for sale. You're going to show up because your keyword query says tennis shoes. Now, somebody came and searched for tennis shoes for sale. Now, if listen to this, if the person actually searched for, or the user actually came into the search engine and searched for the word tennis shoe for sale, you're not going to show up, because this is not the same with what you had in your phrase. Now, let's look at this. Queries my ad won't show against shoes, tennis is not going to show up because it doesn't rhyme with this. You see that, right? Tennis shoe is not going to show up because I had shoes here and I'm having shoe here. I have tennis sneakers. There's no relationship between this and this. All right, let's go further. Now, we're going to be looking at the difference between broad match, exact match, and the phrase match. Now, let's look at the match type. We have the phrase exact match, we have the phrase match, we have the broad match, and we have the broad match modified. We're going to talk about that in a bit. All right, now the symbols for the exact match, you have the keyword in an enclosed bracket, right? For examples, if somebody searches for the word basketballs, that is when your ad is going to show up. Now let's look at the phrase match. The keyword is enclosed in a quotation mark. Now somebody searches for the word buy basket shoes. You see that, right? There's a difference between this and this, because there's a word is added before the actual keyword, so you're going to show up. Broad match, it has no symbol. It has no symbol. Now, buy Jordan shoes, I'm going to show up. Buy basket shoes, I'm going to show up. Buy basketball shoes, I'm going to show up. Buy football shoes, I'm going to show up, and so on and so forth. Now, broad match modified, plus keyword shoes for basketball. All right, having talked about that, we're going to be looking at all right, having explained the different types of keywords, we're going to be looking at how it can actually be used in a real life scenario. Now, I have my keywords here. This is where I'm going to impute the keywords I want my ads to rank for. Right. So I'm going to start with Google gives you the opportunity to enter your product or services you want to advertise, and then they give you suggested keywords based on what you actually entered. Now, for example, let's say I'm selling wine, or I'm setting up an ad, a Google ad for wine. So I'm going to type in wine, and I'm going to come here and click on get keyword suggestions. So Google is going to give me some keyword suggestions that I can actually play around with, and then go get some other keywords from other platforms like the SEMrush and so on and so forth, right? So in a real life scenario, when you have these keywords being populated by Google, you can also update keywords, can replace keywords. Google keep dropping you lots of suggestions, but the fact is this: I wouldn't advise you to just use what Google give you. Yeah, I would advise you to go make some research about the product you want to sell. For example, now if you look at it, I have weekly clicks, I'm going to get 125, weekly cost I'm going to spend 28,000, and cost per click is going to cost, I'm going to spend 230 using these keywords. Now let's see the actual the life scenario, or rather the way we can actually transform our keywords, because while looking at these keywords, every one of them are coming out as a broad match keyword. Now let's see how we can actually convert them from being a broad match into being an exact match, and also being a phrase match. Now let's assume now let's consider the wine. I want to convert this wine from a broad match into an exact match. All I just need to do is to come in here and add my my closed bracket, and automatically it becomes an exact match. Likewise for this, if I have my quotation sign, quotation mark, out and in, automatically it becomes a phrase match. I like that. Let's assume I have this Bellari, let's capitalize this word, Bellari champagne. I want this to come out as an exact match. Sorry for that. I want this to come out as an exact match. I'm gonna have something like this, my close bracket. I'm gonna have it here as well. So this word, this keyword automatically becomes an exact match. Now when you look at it, everything I do here automatically affects my weekly clicks. So in the sense that this Bellari champagne, when I converted it or transformed it from being a broad match into being an exact match, what happened is that my weekly click dropped, my weekly cost also dropped, then my cost per click as well dropped. Now let's look at wine shop. So I'm gonna use wine shop as an exact match and also as a broad match. Now I'm gonna copy that and duplicate it. I'm gonna duplicate that as well. Not duplicate that. So I'm gonna use it as a phrase match. Let's use it as a phrase match and as an exact match as well. And as an exact match as well. So I have this. Now I'm gonna have an update here. All right. So weekly clicks for these keywords. Now in a nutshell, there are some words that I wouldn't advise you to leave as a broad match, because people constantly searches for those words, and it wouldn't be nice for your ads to appear for every query on that keyword. So you try as much as possible to narrow your search, either by making it an exact match or a phrase match. In my next series, I'm going to be explaining to you the reason why I actually told you to learn to narrow your keywords. Alright, now, like I said earlier, don't leverage or don't wait for Google to give you updates, or for Google to give you suggested keywords that you're going to be using. There are lots and lots of free and paid platforms that I'm going to be showing you that you're going to be using doing your keyword searches on, Example of them, let's quickly dive into my slides. Example of them, I'm going to talk about the 10 best keyword research tools. We have the SEMrush. The SEMrush actually have the free version and as well have the paid version. We have the KW Finder, we have the Ahrefs Keyword Explorer, we have the Google Keyword Planner, we have the Growth Bar, we have the Longtail Pro, we have the Majestic, we have the Keyword Tool, we have the SEPStart, we have the Moz Keyword Explorer. Now, these are different keyword tools that can actually help you get the right keyword for a particular product you want to advertise, the keyword you want to be ranked, you want your product to be ranked for. So I would advise you to always leverage on these keyword tools and not depend on Google to give you suggested keywords for your product. I'm not telling you that this is bad, but I would advise you not to leverage on this. Rather, do a research on your own. In my next series I'm going to be showing you how you can actually do a proper research using the Google keyword tools. All right, thank you, see you in my next series. Bye bye.